Hi everyone, good morning. My name is Miguel Martinez, a medical physicist. Nice to meet you. I'm going to present the next work with title Virtual Imaging for Patient Information Radiotherapy Planning and Delivery for Prostate Cancer, a study developed in the Cancer Centers of University Hospital North Midlands, NHS, in collaboration with Keele University in Stoke-on-Trent. In first place, as you may know, the planning of external beam radiotherapy for prostate cancer has to find a fine balance between the dose delivered to the prostate and to neighboring organs by means of medical accelerator or LINAC, like this one represented in this sketch. The aim is to achieve high tumor control with minimal side effects. But it's not always an easy task. The two main organs at risk in this case are the bladder and the rectum, that typically surrounds our target, the prostate, anteriorly and posteriorly, as we can see in this example of a CT scan. Likewise, to complement this introduction, it is accepted the next preparation for prostate radiotherapy in order to reduce side effects. On one hand, empty rectum, to reduce the dose to rectum and improves consistency, and on the other hand, a comfortably full bladder to reduce the dose to bladder and pushing a bowel away from treatment area, as we can see in this picture. While this is the desirable outcome, it is also known that patients find it difficult, even more as the RT sessions are advancing. Moreover, it is accepted that the bladder volume decreases towards the end of the radiotherapy. This may have possible implications on side effects, as we will check quantitatively on the results of this paper. With this in mind, the purpose of this work was to assess whether provision of information radiotherapy planning and delivery with PERT, the Virtual Environment Radiotherapy Training System, improves not only patient satisfaction, but also compliance to preparation for prostate radical radiotherapy. This was assessed by measuring bladder and rectal volumes and separations at different time points. A quality of life questionnaire was also used to measure early side effects caused by radiotherapy. Within the material and methods followed, our study design includes 96 patients with prostate adenocarcinoma with curative intent, randomized in two cohorts. The first one pre-birth, in where the information on radiotherapy planning and delivery is given prior to any radiotherapy fraction, and post-birth, after the last radiotherapy fraction, and whose characteristics can be seen in this table aside. This research is approved by the Ethics Committee. Among the information given to the patients, there are written procedures explaining how to do their preparations to ensure consistency in bladder filling and bowel emptying. Apart from that, the PERT system provided by this company gives invaluable information with or based on the set of images, the planning CT and the RT plan, customized, updated by the DICOM standard. This is projected into a specific room and visualized on a one-to-one basis through 3D glasses. In this session, the radiographers invite patients to bring some relatives or friends. The eligible patients, those ones who understood and consented this study, were invited to fill a questionnaire of life developed by this radio-oncology group, ELTH, and by which the gravity of the side effects to radiotherapy was quantified by means of scores from 1, not at all, to 4, very much. Radiotherapy was performed by means of 10 megavoltage beams delivered by IX clinics, similar to this one, and volumetric modulated ACT therapy, in which the treatment is divided in a compendium of control points, in where the dose rate, the speed and position of gantry, the MLC positioning, and the monitored units were variable. The prescription was done according to the national protocol, 74 gray in 37 fractions, to the mean of the planning target volume, consisting on the expansion of the clinical target volume of prostate, avoiding rectum. The next step was to show how the virtual reality program was embedded into the radiotherapy workflow with patients. After the first stages of patient assessment made by the radiation oncologist and the simulation made in the CT of the department, there was a volume delineation with the controlling targets and organ risks, and the performance of some treatment planning procedures by dosimetry planning, the plan review, and the physics checks and QA by physicists. So the new stage of PERT, which takes approximately 40 minutes for patient, is embedded either before delivery for the pre-PERT cohort or after the treatment delivery for the post-PERT cohort. The last stage is to do the follow-up of patients with the questionnaire of life. Within the treatment planning system software that is called Eclipse, some bladder and rectal measurements were performed for the planning CT and some combined CT scans on the days 1, 2, 3 and then weekly pre-correction. Among the data collected to highlight the bladder volume if seen, distances anterior, posterior, right, left and half sub-inf in this view for the bladder, also the location of the central slide for the prostate and the rectum anterior, posterior, right, left to the patient separation and the expected central slide for prostate and plus 3 and minus 3 centimeters with regards to this slice. Also to add, there was need of developing a model in MATLAB version 11 for the bladder volume when this was not completely seen on a combined CT scan. It was not possible to repeat combined CTs because this would have signified extra radiation in such a busy department like ours, and this wouldn't be ethical. Alternatively, by our fitting process, we correlated the bladder volume seen in Eclipse PCT and the bladder volume estimated by ellipsoid by the measurements per image of these three parameters A, B, C, distances in the cross-sectional plane, and C in this view. This was done in a subpopulation near 50% of the total images, above 1,000. Lastly, there was a statistical analysis with the p-values applying to sample t-test in Microsoft Office. Within the results of the study, to highlight the linear regression outcomes, which validates the usage of the bladder volume estimation by ellipsoids. As we can see in this plot, there is a satisfactory correlation between both magnitudes, with a coefficient of nearly 0.94, and an average difference between both measures of nearly 0.4%. Secondly, the bladder volumes are represented in this plot, and the trends four different time points in radiotherapy. The triangles for the prepared group and the squares in blue for the second one. Both groups show a decrease in this volume from a value nearly 330 milliliters to 250, what in terms of relative analysis represents between a 15 and a 25% of decrease. These square bars represent the double of the standard deviations. Regarding the rectal results, this plot shows the trends in the average product of rectal separation anterior-posterior times right-left for the three anatomical points of measurement, A, center of prostate, B, plus 3 cm superior, and C, inferior, in red prepared cohort. As we can see, there are not statistically significant differences. Secondly, we calculate the number of combined CTs per patient and group, having 39 and 38.5. The analysis of the quality of life data are shown in this table for both groups with the average of the scores. For bladder symptoms, we have an increase on the score, but then a reduction. For bowel, there is an increase or higher toxicities with time, but then this reduction is stopped. For both organ at risk, we have non-significant differences between both groups from the fourth week on, as we can see in this table, with p-values higher than 0.05. And finally, we have arrived to the conclusions. Our previous studies have shown that most patients receiving radiotherapy welcome virtual reality tools to better understand how radiotherapy is planned and given. Despite the improvement of patients' experience and satisfaction, the present randomized study did not show quantitatively any relevant difference in patients' compliance. Further work is still needed, with perhaps bigger cohort of patients. In the future, this study may provide cancer centers with a useful tool to audit local protocols regarding patients' preparations and training for prostate radiotherapy. Thank you for listening and all the best.